second advent of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross. And this is mentioned in Luke's Gospel, chapter 23, verse 43. And Jesus said unto him, Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. The first utterance, thank you, Dr. Simon, for showing us the beauty of forgiveness. That was the Lord's prayer to our Father in heaven. But the second utterance was to one of the thieves that was also crucified beside him. The benefactor crucified in the middle and two malefactors on either side. One of the thieves was railing on the Lord, ridiculing him, if you will, making a mockery, saying, If thou be Christ, save thyself and save us. However, verses from 39 onwards of the same chapter, we see the other malefactor showed a different attitude. Many people, in a friendly way or in a light-hearted, light-noted way, often quote this thief so that they also in the last minute will somehow turn and move into the glorious realms. But I want to place before you the seven utterances of the thief that led Christ to offer paradise to him that day. The seven utterances of the penitent thief. Luke's Gospel, chapter 23, verse 40. The penitent thief, answering, rebuked the other proud thief, saying, first of all, dost not thou fear God? The thief exhibited fear of God. Fear of God is the basis, foundation upon which salvation can be built. This thief exhibited the fear of God. Don't we remember one of the teachings of Christ to the disciples? Not to fear the one who kills only the body, but to fear him who is able to kill the body and cast the soul into the place of punishment. This thief exhibited that true fear of God. The psalmist says in Psalm 130, verse 4, there is forgiveness in thee that thou mayest be feared. Praise be to God. This thief, no wonder, obtained forgiveness from Jesus that he be seen with Christ in paradise that day. Fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. And Apostle Paul writes to Timothy saying, true wisdom is being wise unto salvation. Praise be to God. The first utterance of the thief is, fear God. Secondly, in the same verse, he tells the other thief the reason to fear God. The second utterance is, seeing thou art in the same condemnation. Wages of sin is death. Christ our Lord is life eternal. This thief acknowledged his state. I am in this state for my fault. I am the cause that I am nailed to the cross today. That thief acknowledged. Whosoever covers his sins shall not prosper. But he that confesses and forsakes shall obtain mercy. Praise be to God. This thief, in his second utterance, acknowledged his true state. As the portions were read from Isaiah chapter 53, our transgressions, our punishment was all laid on him. But how can we obtain the benefit of the cross? It is by acknowledging our state. This thief, in his second utterance, acknowledged his true state. Praise be to God. Thirdly, Luke 23, verse 41, where he says, we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds. Salvation replaces judgment when we accept the divine verdict. This thief did not avoid, run away, or even turn away from the divine verdict. For he says, we are in this condemnation. Indeed, it is a just condemnation. We receive the due reward of our deeds. He realized his works were not worthy of appreciation, that his deeds were contemptible. He acknowledged his state and he accepted the divine judgment upon his soul. To be able to accept the divine judgment, one needs to have a proper understanding of God, without which we will not be able to acknowledge his judgments. For the Bible says, Abraham judged God righteously, meaning he understood God in the right way, and that right understanding brought the clarity of divine verdict in every situation of life that will all culminate into the final judgment. So the third utterance of the thief is a humble acceptance of the divine verdict. Fourthly, the same verse, verse 41. But this man, meaning to the benefactor nailed between them both, to Christ he pointed out and said, but this man hath done nothing amiss. He acknowledged the holiness of God in Jesus the Lord. Salvation is a result of such a confession. Forgiveness is the product of such an understanding. Freedom is the result of a heart that sees holiness belongs to God. A life that acknowledges the holiness of God obtains that salvation through Jesus Christ our Lord. It cannot be obtained by questioning God, it is but by approving of God's holiness. confessing that holiness belongs to God. Fifthly, in verse 42, the thief said unto Jesus, Lord. If we believe with our heart and confess with our mouth that Jesus is Lord, hallelujah, truly salvation belongs to that soul. No wonder that this penitent thief, in his seven utterances, on the fifth, he calls Jesus Lord. Whilst the people were all beholding Christ on the cross, the rulers, the Roman rulers, were deriding him that was nailed to the cross. While the soldiers were mocking Jesus on the cross. While the other malefactor is railing Jesus, this thief calls Jesus Lord. It is easy to call him Lord when we see miracles. It is easy to call him Lord when, with few loaves and fishes, multitudes are satisfied and fragments are collected in baskets. When the dead are raised and lepers are cleansed and the blind see and the lame walk. When we see these great mighty deeds, it's absolutely easy to call him Lord. But when whole mob had turned against him, that even a thief could not offer respect to him, this thief calls him Lord. Praise be to God. The sixth utterance of the thief is, in the same verse, the last portion, I'll come to the middle portion as the seventh. The last portion he says, when thou comest in thy kingdom. What a tremendous faith that this man who is nailed to the cross, just like how I am, I will die, he also will die, but he will rise again and come back again in his kingdom. Faith upon Christ and his kingdom is the backbone of salvation. Hallelujah. This thief, in his sixth utterance, exhibited the faith of the elect. The faith that he had in the soon coming kingdom of the Lord Jesus Christ. When thou comest in thy kingdom. He did not look at Jesus as a defeat or a failure, but he looked at Jesus as a victorious king. Only faith will enable us to see Christ the crucified as the power of God. As the scriptures were read from 1 Corinthians chapter 1, Jews seek for signs while the Greeks seek for wisdom, but the preaching of the cross is foolishness to them which perish, but it is the power of God to them which are saved. Hallelujah. This thief saw Christ the crucified as the soon coming king. And the seventh utterance of the thief is, remember me, plead for mercy, remember me. If we cannot approach God with our good deeds, how can we approach him while we are filled with bad deeds? This thief shows the right way is a plea for mercy. Have mercy on me, O Lord. Before I conclude, let me say, even as the worst sinner has got something to repent about, or many things to repent about, even a matured, godly man still has something to turn to God for. We will be doing the right thing this day if we can take a leaf out of this man's walk in the last moments. went through all the steps of salvation. To him, Jesus said, "Verily I say unto thee, this day thou shalt be with me in paradise." May God help us to repent and turn to him, that when we breathe our last here, that we will open our eyes in his presence. Shall we close our eyes for a word of prayer, please? Heavenly Father, standing in your awesome presence, I humble myself, and we pray for one another that, Lord, at every stage of our life, we do see things that we need to repent and turn to you. I'm no better than this thief and far worse. But Lord, it is your mercy that has brought us into the family of God. We pray that as each and every one of us will repent, the assurance that we will be with you in your kingdom fill our soul. We commit this prayer to you in the name of Jesus. Amen.